Tinnitus is a phantom sound described as a continuous ringing, buzzing, or whistling. This sound is perceived within the ears or the head that occurs without any external source of sound. However, it is not the ear that is responsible for tinnitus, though it may be one factor. Instead, the cause of a person's tinnitus can be found in the brain. Sound information obtained by the ears are processed in the brain in a very specific area known as the auditory cortex. The auditory cortex is divided up into areas that are responsible for processing different pitches in a similar way to keys on a piano. Under normal circumstances, there is always a baseline of ongoing neural activity. When sound is present, however, the neural activity increases above baseline. When there are no sounds present, this activity is at a baseline that establishes your neural code for silence. However, anything which causes us to lose our hearing can disrupt this internal keyboard, whether by medication, loud noises, or just getting older. With fewer cochlear cells relaying information, incoming sounds generate weaker nerve signals. To compensate, the brain devotes more energy to monitoring the hearing pathway to get a clear signal, resulting in synchronous neural activity. Unfortunately, this increased background neural activity is what causes the perception of tinnitus. One way to disrupt this abnormal neural synchrony is a treatment called acoustic coordinated reset neuromodulation. This acoustic neuromodulation therapy involves using the frequency of the tinnitus as the center tone, and then adding some higher and some lower frequency sounds to randomly stimulate the area around the auditory cortex where the tinnitus frequency is found. Using a complex mathematical algorithm, a personalized sound prescription for a tinnitus sufferer is created. This basically encompasses a series of tones which are transmitted to the nerve cells in the brain of the patient in such a way that the cell's abnormal synchronous activity is disrupted and hyperactivity is reduced. These customized four tones are spatially and temporally staggered in such a way that it forces the synchronous nerve cells into different subgroups, each with its own unique rhythm different from the original tinnitus neural rhythm. Short pauses between the tonal stimulation signals remodel the nerve network. If repeated regularly and often enough, these stimulation signals hopefully will reduce the hyperactivity to such an extent that the abnormal neural synchrony will be permanently reversed, thereby resolving the tinnitus. Ideally, the tone sequence should be listened to with headphones for 4 to 6 hours a day for 6 or more months, though improvement can be seen in as little as 3 months. For more information on where acoustic neuromodulation treatment can be obtained, read the text description box.